Hello everybody, and a happy 2024 for you all. That's our special guest for today. After the last special guest, the Randy Savage soundboard, was such a success, I thought we'd just, you know, try something out.
Happy 2024.
Yeah. And I just realized I forgot to put up the wrong, the fake loading screens, but it doesn't matter.
Oh, oops.
Because, you know, there's nothing, no purpose for those fake loading screens anyway. I just thought they would be neat, but here they are, not being there. So you can see the, thing.
The thing.
That's always there. And I sometimes put secret messages in the text box, but not this time.
Hey, that's a pretty secret message.
Well, usually it's a period, sometimes it's something else, but this time it's a colon 3.
It's usually just, like, a random mash of letters, though. Or a period.
Yeah. So I hope people can see the stream. You can see the stream, people on the stream, right?
I can see the stream.
That's good, then I will just start. I just pressed the button, like, at the time I said start, so it's just you can get a little bit of an idea of how bad the delay is again.
It's like 5 seconds.
Probably. I mean, it's been worse in the past. But this is still pretty bad.
It's not unbearable.
I mean, not like you'll notice. It's just I'll notice. That's the thing, and I'll let you know that I notice. And our first match, I actually, you know, have the match card again. Like, right here.
Yeah.
But I'm not gonna put it up now, because the scene is supposed to start. There it is!
Yay!
It's some people that have met. Okay. So yeah, Junpei and Rara actually booked this show, and they decided to pick like the tag teams at random.
Yeah, because like, there's only like two or three tag teams, and like they're all lame except for the ones that are like reigning champions like forever. So we were just like, okay, let's just do a lottery and randomly pick tag team partners.
Yeah, pretty much. And this is you informing me of that glorious thing that you picked. And of course, it was face versus face and face.
Yeah, we originally drew face twice. So there's that.
Yeah. I would have liked to see that happening, but, you know, can't get
I almost was just like, let's keep it, but I don't know.
Well, I would have went with it, though, because...
Yeah, well, we should have just done it then.
I would have just pretended that the other guy is not face, but actually heel, or ladder hall, or however, I don't know. Oh yeah, there, I actually say it right here. Good.
It's almost like he wrote this thing.
Yeah. See? Before the stream I said, hey, I can't remember what's happening this time because I made it literally today, but I guess I didn't remember that part. But oh well. Hopefully I will surprise myself some more today. Should be fun. Actually, the movie came out 8 years ago, I just remembered, but
yeah.
Hey, who cares?
It's close enough.
And of course, I think that we're all playing a different game here. Because clearly, I just have the match card in my hand. Like, literal cards. Wait, is it really Griff? Did I fuck up? Don't tell me I fucked up. Actually, it's Anil. I picked Anil. I just wrote Griff here. I didn't do anything wrong except I wrote the wrong thing here.
No, I think that's correct.
No?
Actually,
yeah, it is. Okay. I am very, very confused.
I can tell.
Please don't do anything that could confuse me more.
Okay.
Yeah, there it says Griff, right here where you can't see it, where it doesn't say it, it says it's a secret.
Shit's a secret.
That's why I'm confused. I can't handle secrets very well.
Secrets are very, yeah.
Well, they can be cool, but sometimes they're also confusing me, so yeah.
It's
and
okay.
The first match already started on my TV. Well, it hasn't. The entrance started. And here comes our hero, Heavenator. I think he's the fastest champ.
Yep.
He's wearing the belt at least.
Mm-hmm.
See, the thing is, I can't remember who the champions are.
The game will remember for you, maybe.
No, it won't. Like, sometimes it will, because when I do title matches outside of story mode, it will remember, but if you do it in story mode, it won't. So, yeah. Mostly they are in story mode, so they don't remember him a lot. But I think the Kawaii champ is still evil? Or is it? No, it's Aurora, right?
I don't know.
I think Aurora actually won it again? Or maybe evil took it back again?
I have no idea.
Yeah, who's Superstar Champ?
Is that Junpei or is that Flamander?
I think it might be Junpei.
Cause I can't. I mean, like.
Well, Flamander is the LPFWA champ. That much I know.
Okay, yeah, cause I always get LP Superstar and LPFWA mixed up. I don't know.
Well, yeah, they both have LP in their names.
Yeah, I mean, it's confusing. No, I'm the one that's confused.
I'm so sorry. I haven't seen Skier in a while, I think. But there he is, coming to the ring.
Yeah. We figured he deserved a match, and since he's a jobber, we gave him Buskus.
Of course. He would deserve a match at a shot at the Buskus. I think he's had a shot before, but that was against Soar. He didn't win it back then, so we called him a bad jobber. But now he has a second chance. Let's all root for Skier to lose. Or we could also do for Heavenator, but that would... Well, see, I'm confused again. Okay, I'm just gonna stop. Okay, so there's some punching going on right now, I can tell that much. It's pretty good, I guess.
Yeah, it's some quality punching.
Yeah.
That was a kick. Whoa.
Guess what, a suplex.
And a suplex.
This is amazing, I'm gonna tell you. So far it looks like Skier is failing at losing.
Yeah.
Maybe he's just not bad enough. Oh my. He's definitely doing too well. He's even doing actual moves.
I mean, what's up with that?
Maybe we just gotta stop seeing him as a jobber and give him a shot at the LBFWA title.
he's not part of the number one contenders match, so I don't think he can do that.
I know, but fun fact, he actually held that title at some point. I mean, that part wasn't canon, but it happened.
Yeah, I was gonna say, that wasn't canon, though.
Well, we keep claiming it wasn't canon, but we somehow survived that thing, where rocks fell and everybody died. And Vince McMahon bought LPWA and fired everybody. Because, yeah. That's the thing that happened.
What a jerk.
I mean, it didn't happen because clearly it's not canon, because it would mean that Skier was the LPWA champion once. I think in the final episode, I'll just reveal that everything is canon. Spoilers. And another move by Skier, big surprise. He did the same move twice in a row.
Hey, if it works.
Well, it's called spamming, though. That's not really good in fighting games, because this is clearly a competitive fighting game. You can tell because they're, it's actually just completely random. I played the game before.
Oh, Skier's doing pretty well.
Yeah. And that's actually his finisher.
Is it?
It is. Yeah, it's supposed to look wimpy.
Oh, that was really close.
Yeah. I honestly don't think I've seen Heaven Eater win before, because he's been in two or three tag matches together with Kalon Zombie before, and they lost every time.
Mm-hmm.
I think he's had one or two solo matches too, though. Which didn't really end well for him either. Seeing as he's the Buskus now.
Yeah, I'm kind of glad that he is, though, because that means we get to see more of him. I like Heavenator.
Yeah. Like, I like Kalon Zombie and Heavenator as characters. Like, when they showed up, I tried to build them up as this tag team. Which they are. They are a tag team. But
they're just not very good.
Yeah. Teams. Like, we need to tag Buskus, maybe. They can hold it and defend it at the beginning of every show. Yeah, how about... Yeah, man, I should have had that idea earlier, though. But I don't know if the world can handle two Buskus matches per show. Would be a little much. Excuse me, anime related, it's not a fetish.
What is it, then?
It is just appreciation of the fine arts.
Oh.
I mean, there's three characters with assless chaps in LPWA. Like, there's Heavenator, there's Kalon Zombie, and then there's Immortan Cho. Just Immortan Cho wears pants under the assless chaps, which really is his choice, I guess, but if he thinks it works, he should do it. You can see the way. But a true way to wear those assless chaps, of course, is to not wear any pants underneath.
If you say so.
I know things about assless chaps. In fact, I'm wearing some right now.
Oh yeah. I wish I hadn't seen that, but...
Well, I didn't tell you to look.
I mean, you're gonna say things like that, you gotta expect them to look.
Well, I was gonna say that it's a lie, but then you actually confirmed it, so I guess I'm wearing assless chaps now. Too bad I can't adjust things on the fly and just give myself assless chaps from a match. I changed. That's my wrestling costume. I changed. Yeah, that works. That's as good an excuse as any. But hey, now Happy Nation's actually taking it back. Maybe Skier wanted to make it interesting.
Well, it's working. This is a lot longer than I expected it to take.
And Skier does the move that's supposed to be really powerful, but does exactly zero damage. And he's really excited about it too.
He's like, check this out.
Yeah, I did no damage. Yeah.
He's really just here to entertain.
Well, yeah, that's like somebody threw the idea around in our Discord earlier today that a wrestling game where everybody knows it's fake and just have to make it as entertaining as possible would be really fun. Sad thing is, such a thing doesn't exist. Because it would be good. It would be better than this piece of thing, whatever it is. I don't even want to say shit because that would be an insult to shit. It's just horrible, this game, like, it's entertaining us, of course, and that's a good thing.
But not in the right ways.
Well, also in the right ways, but it's clearly not what they intended. The game could be good, but it isn't. In fact, the most fun way oh my god!
Whoa, what? What?
I didn't see that coming! I didn't see that! Not after how the match started!
Until it...
Yeah, I didn't see that coming.
Okay, well, I guess we've got a new Buskus champ.
It's Skier now!
Yay!
Congrats, Skier! We have to tell him later.
Yeah.
I bet he'll be excited to hear that.
He probably will, actually.
Heavenator, I don't even know what your finisher is anymore. Because it's never happened. It's probably something really exciting and flashy, though. And then later, I was thinking maybe something like Devil May Cry, where you get like a style meter that builds up. Only it's, not as temporary, which just disappears after a few seconds. Or maybe it should be exactly that way. I don't know. I'm not exactly a game designer or anything. Oh my, look at this thing. That's happening. This is going to be really intense, I guess. Because the match, Iggy versus BNF, is up next.
Yeah.
In case you don't believe me, here's the match card. It says Iggy versus BNF, and next to it is a bunny. Because that's how we
a
do things here.
A very happy bunny.
And yeah, BNF has an office. It's Iggy who doesn't have an office. And he has an office, but it's a hallway. A table in the hallway, in fact. Currently residing in there are Chinpei and Rara. But yeah, obviously, BNF, myself, have a score to settle.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. It's gonna be a once-in-a-lifetime thing. We're gonna settle this today, whatever it is. There will be blood. Probably. Yeah. I mean, you can tell that we just hate each other.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Oh my. The tension in the air, it's real. Oh my god!
What?
Just wait until the next line. Yeah! I can see the future, guys! Oh my god. Yeah. Okay, so that match is going to happen. I'm going to wear pants for it. Much like it did in that scene. And the portrait on the wall is probably Vince McMahon, because this is Vince McMahon's office. I think I said at some point that Vince McMahon is clearly dead. Which is sad, because dead people are sad. But hey, look at that, a match is gonna come up in a second, that's gonna be less sad.
Yay!
Even though it's two friends fighting over something, so it's actually still kinda sad. But hey, we got flashy entrances! And a funny Final Fantasy remix about getting drunk and my ass.
There it is.
I'm going to the ring with style, and I can talk while I'm doing it. I'm just that good. I can even drink while I do it. Yeah.
Where does that drink come from?
Magic.
Oh, sure, okay.
Oh god, I just accidentally called my hairdresser on my phone. How the hell did that happen?
What?
Good thing they're not open right now, because it's some kind of insane time over here in Germany. Otherwise, I would have had to talk to them.
Who wants to talk to people? Like, really?
Yeah. I don't know. I don't typically talk to people. Except my friend BNF, who I'm fighting today. I talk to him all the time.
Yeah.
He responds with wisdom, usually. But today, he wants to kill me.
Well, I don't think he wants to kill you.
I mean, he just wants to make me bleed bad. I'm sure we'll be fine. I have no idea how this will end, by the way, because I've never seen those two guys fight. I mean, me and BNF, we've never fought. That's a better way to phrase it. Looks like I get thrown around a bit. As expected. Because BNF is notorious for never losing, kinda.
I'm not sure that he's ever lost. Maybe like once, but I can't remember like if or when.
I know he never lost in the old LPFWA, but he might have lost in this new one?
I don't think he's had a match in Season 2, has he?
He has had matches where he filled in for me, at least.
Well, I don't think he... I don't know. I can't remember.
Yeah. See, it's not really important anyway.
His record is better than yours, and that's what matters.
Yeah, I lost to Skier once.
And you know where Skier is now.
Don't remind me. In my defense, I have a custom signature move. Those do very little damage. Oh, look at that. Sims Magic showed up perfect.
Yep.
Oh my god, I did a thing. It was actually kind of impressive. I reversed a move. And now I'm on the floor again. See, I shouldn't really celebrate every time I actually get in a move, a good one, because he's just gonna take it away from me immediately. Now look at me winning, that would be hilarious.
I think we all knew how this was gonna go, we just wanted to see it happen.
Yeah. It's such a long-standing feud too. It started last night.
Yeah, it's...
I mean, last night in 2024.
Are we saying that, or would it have been 2023? Like, is this New Year's? Or...
Oh yeah, that right. This is New Year's. So it would be 2023. So now, yeah, yeah. Okay, good. Thanks for reminding me that it's New Year's today. Probably. Well, we gotta, like, okay, so yeah.
Yeah?
Again, the anniversary for LPFWA was the first show of this season, but the first season actually started a couple months later in 2013 than this one started in 2015, so... Well, let's just pretend, okay?
Yeah,
we're on the moon.
Time that's not accounted for. Just,
we're on the moon. We have an excuse.
Yeah.
The moon acts differently, I guess. How long's it been on the moon?
Yeah, we sometimes go back in time, and it's just like really weird.
Yeah.
And...
You know, does the moon even have proper days? I don't know. Should have days though, right? I don't know how things work that spin in the space thing. Ha! I
Whoa.
Flipped them off! Yeah! And that was my custom signature move that does basically no damage. But it did it.
You're actually putting up a fight right now.
Yeah. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do if I win. Oh yeah, next week we'll have a pay-per-view, by the way. It'll be Tox Party. I'm not going to do a Tox for when I win, though, because... Or should I? Hey, I did the move to zero damage!
Yay!
Yeah. So I think I'm just gonna count how many times people do that move today.
It's two so far, right?
And that's his finisher, I think. Yep, I think that's it. I think I'm probably dead now.
I don't know.
Yes, okay, I'm dead.
Yeah. Rip Iggy. I'm the new owner of LPFWA.
Oh no, the battery of my controller is low.
Oh no.
Well, I don't care. Oh, I actually should. I think I should care. Let's just fix this, I guess. Wait, how do I fix this? I'm gonna fix this, trust me. I just gotta do stuff.
Go for it.
If you just heard that noise, that was my controller falling to the ground. It's dead too.
I did hear that.
Very nice.
A moment of silence for the controller, everybody.
It's alive again.
Oh, okay, good, good, good.
Look at that new and amazing camera angle.
Look at who's talking.
The guy who just died. But I guess I'm not really dead, but... Maybe I'm also immortal?
Oh, I don't know. It's an interesting twist.
Yeah, that would be interesting. And now it is revealed what this entire dispute was about. It was truly worthy of such a long-running feud.
Oh yeah, I mean... The last slice of pizza is a commodity.
Yeah, I was gonna make like a promo package for this, where I just tried to hype it up real good, like it's the best thing ever, but I didn't have the time, or actually, you know, I didn't want to do it. I just would like for it to just magically appear in my computer. And that's a lesson of today. Maybe friendship is more important than pizza, sometimes.
Maybe rarely. I mean, I guess when there's infinite pizza, it kind of diminishes the value a little bit, but...
Well, you say there's infinite pizza, but why is Iggy saying he has to order one then?
Because...
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, exactly. I guess I just don't know there's infinite pizza. Nice.
Nice.
The good old loading screen. What match do we have next? Oh, that's a loading screen? Oh, I might add this. Okay, so. It's actually the mysterious CoComs number one contenders match. With
Yay!
The secret participants, which are no longer a secret. Alright. This loading screen might just last forever.
Infinite pizza, infinite loading screens.
Oh, yes. Oh, there it is. Haven't seen FaZe in a while either.
We could have seen two FaZes, but.
Yeah. You know, I am glad that FaZe comes to the ring and his gas mask is not all shiny like it was in the past for some reason, which is not something that I actively changed or anything. It just sometimes is really damn shiny and sometimes it's not. Because WWA 2K14, yeah.
WWA?
A-E, it's, yeah. What's the A stand for in WWA though? Certainly not entertainment, because that would be neat.
Association, maybe?
Like federation, but they didn't call it entertainment, because it's sports entertainment. Clearly. I just don't know. Why FaZe's theme for some reason has German lyrics?
Because?
And I think Zanzibar Ham proposed a new song.
Oh yeah, he did this morning, didn't he?
I forgot to actually implement it. But why?
Oh, well.
Why should I change
one last
this?
One too raw for this one.
Why should I change this? It's good. I mean, it's odd. The caveman would have this. This tune. But the tune actually inspired me to give him that particular haircut. Which is good, because that's a great haircut for him for some reason.
So does that mean when you change the theme, you change the haircut?
No, I will not change the haircut ever. Unless he wants me to.
Okay.
I don't know if I pointed out before, but this is the exact same body type and face as Mihuya Ale had.
You only... bring it up every single time.
Good. I keep forgetting. But did you know that Mihuya is still an alternate costume for him?
Yes.
So I could just bring him back anytime and he'd be called Sans Abraham instead. Hey, it's Atzel.
Yay!
Gotta root for your brother, I guess?
Yeah. I sure will do that.
He's got a skull on his shirt, that's how you know he's cool.
Pretty much. He's so cool. And not at all weird.
Yeah. So who's next? I could just wait. Instead, I'm going to look at the match card and notice that it doesn't say it. Good.
Good job.
It's Griff, though, right? It's Griff.
Okay. Yeah, it's Griff.
It's Griff, okay. I could have just looked at the TV because I can see the future, but I didn't.
Whoa! Does that come with being immortal?
Nah, it just comes with having a capture device that has long delay. Wow, that wasn't a very fun answer, was it?
No, it wasn't.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
And we actually haven't seen Griff in a while either. A lot of the guys that just haven't shown up for a while show up again now. I've probably forgotten about Griff. He's cool. Even though he doesn't like anime.
This is gonna be great.
That's what the man on the TV said, that's also talking at the same time we're talking.
That's right.
It must be great having two commentary tracks at the same time. And one of them is just canned commentary from the game. Which some people prefer, and I can't understand that. But, hey. That would also be kind of boring.
Hey, you gotta learn about them coal miners.
Yeah, every single fucking time, the coal miners. I don't get it. I mean, okay, I know by now that it's supposed to be kind of a joke about Michael Cole. Because he's called Cole, and that's totally hilarious. But...
yeah, it's super funny.
Hey, maybe Griff did show up a week ago. But, and by a week ago, I mean 2 weeks ago. But 1 week ago in canon,
but canon.
Right,
canon.
Now it's 2014, New Year's.
20, what year is it?
I don't care. No, not 2014, 2024, yeah, my god. 2014 was like 2 years ago now. Holy crap,
no,
I'm old.
It would have been 10 years ago.
Yeah! My god, I'm even older than I thought. So, my bets are on Sans Abraham winning, because he always wins, apparently.
Yeah, I think mine is too.
Someone will correct me in the chat now, because by now, the people watching know more about LPFWA than I do. Which isn't surprising.
Not sure if that's good or bad.
Yeah, well, it means we have very dedicated fans.
Or maybe it just means we're lazy.
Yeah. Hey, at least I'm not as lazy as Skier, who didn't even read the thread after a while. He just showed up and, hey, why is there not a show today? I said it like in chat.
Yeah.
And in the thread. Oh. Yeah. Oh my goodness. Oh, Face is getting punched. So Face is with Sans Abraham, I think, right? Yeah, he is.
Yep.
Well, Face is also pretty good, but Griff is also pretty good. But can... well, Griff has carried tag matches before. I think he can do it again. But then again, he has to contend with some guy who was LP Superstar Champion at some point, and with Sans Abraham, who has never lost.
Oh, yeah. Yep. Well, has he never?
Maybe he did. It's just, if he did, I don't remember it.
I don't know.
Well, yeah. Might be the first time losing for him, though, that I can remember, if he lost before.
there's the tag.
That was indeed a tag. And Face gets the shit kicked out of him, of course. I'm just still waiting on the chat correcting me on Sans Abraham's record, but I guess I am correct for
once. Yeah, I'm waiting too.
There's one guy who actually kind of actually knows more about LFWA than everybody else, who just does a lot of stuff on the wiki, but I don't know who he is.
Yeah.
Actually, I haven't looked at the wiki in such a long time. Maybe I should. Hey, look, the bunny ad!
Best ad.
It's not even an ad, it's just a bunny.
That's why it's the best one.
With sunglasses. Yeah, you can see the reflection of the sunglasses. There's nothing interesting in it, though.
What is that? It's like a window, and there's something beneath it.
It is the bunny soul. Anyway, that's Griff's finisher.
Uh-oh.
And he did it right on Sans Abraham. Oh my god. No.
What? Oh, so close.
Yeah. He's not gonna have it, not today. Unless, maybe later, who knows.
I was about to say, where's Atzel? He was just to the left.
Well, yeah, he got dealt with, I guess.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, there he is again.
Yep.
He's fine, much like I survived dying. Again and kicks out again.
Yep.
But doesn't Sans Abraham also have another match today? I'm confused though.
No.
I thought he was also in the number one contenders match, but he isn't.
No, we tried to book it so that like everyone had one match and we got some new talent and some unused talent.
Oh yeah, right, there's that one character I hope I made the entrance for. All I had to do was switch the song, because it was basically a character made by Action Shakespeare, which I just downloaded. I think I put it in, maybe? Don't be surprised. You probably won't notice anyway.
Well, no, I won't.
Unless you happen to remember the song he picked, but, you know, I doubt it.
I don't think I ever even looked.
Well, yeah. Oh, I also forgot to switch Bun Bun's song again and entrance. And even with me not doing stuff, making LPFWA happen is still pretty damn time consuming. That seems like a powerful move.
Yeah. Oh.
And again!
Yeah.
I hope that's not his finisher and he just did it twice on Atzel, because that's sad.
Doesn't seem like a finisher to me.
Well, I don't know. It seems like a powerful move.
I suppose.
It stands out for sure, though. Oh, Chunpei's song! Chunpei's not wrestling today, so if I tell you that I totally switched it,
but then if you say that and then you forget to actually switch it,
then I
the next
said
time
it,
he shows up.
No. Then I say I switch it back to Troll and it related.
Oh.
Because that's just the kind of guy I am. I'll totally
so
do it. Gotta remember, switch it. Like, switching songs is hard, guys. No, it seriously is. Like, it's...
There's so many loading screens.
It's that, too. It's just fucking annoying, though. First, I have to put it on a USB stick. Then I have to put that USB stick into the PS3 and put the song on the PS3. Then I have to go through, like, 10 loading screens. And then I have to select the song. And then I have to save, which is at least one more loading screen. So it's totally understandable that it wouldn't want to do it, even though it seems like such a simple thing to do.
Yeah.
It's not 10 loading screens, they're more like 3. But let's just
keep... Oh, is it gonna work? Is it gonna happen?
No! Oh, what?!
Hey!
What?! What the fuck?! He's never-
Yay!
No! Whoa! Oh, no. That went farther than whoa. No. This is noteworthy, okay?
I knew it would happen.
This is noteworthy. This is the most notable thing that's happened today. Because the hot tags never work. And that one almost worked. Like, the first half of the QuickTime event, it worked.
Oh.
Okay.
Well, we've got our number one contender for a tech team.
Yeah.
Now.
I gotta remember all this for next week when the matches happen. I should probably write down the results, but I'm not.
Oh yeah, results.
I usually don't write them down though. I just do it the day after, normally. When I put the timestamps in the video description. I'm sure no one uses the timestamps, but I do.
I've used them before.
Good, my work is not for nothing. My friend's uncle who works at 2K swears he saw an AI hot tag work. Well, we've seen it almost work just now.
Yeah.
And I think it happened, I don't actually watch VGCW, but apparently it has worked once there and was the hottest shit ever. Alright, music. It's of course one of my 10,000 Mega Man remixes. Of course you would book that match, so I can be friends with Ganef again.
Well, yeah. Gotta help you out sometimes.
So, are you still playing poker, and is he still playing Yu-Gi-Oh?
It's hard to tell anymore. I mean, the cards are kind of getting mixed up, so... Like, I've got some poker cards and some Yu-Gi-Oh cards in my hand. I just don't know what to do anymore.
How does that even... okay. Like, how many attack points does a Hearts 2 have?
Two, obviously.
That's pretty bad, though.
I mean...
Hey, look at Junpei! And how much he loves Annihilated.
Hey, you... That is something I would have said.
I know, that's why I wrote that line.
Good job. You really know me, Iggy.
And that's something Junpei would say, probably.
Probably.
Oh, now that people are making Yu-Gi-Oh jokes in chat, very good. I was about to say maybe we'd need like 4 Blue Eyes White Dragons, but I think it's limited to 3 in Yu-Gi-Oh! I don't know though.
I couldn't tell you.
Well, I actually played Yu-Gi-Oh! Once. And I think cards are usually limited to 3 per deck. but I have no idea about the rules anymore. I just know that there's like attack points and life points and stuff, and if you lose all your life points, you're dead forever.
Yeah, that's yeah. It's a very dangerous card game.
And it, just so you know, I have to put like I say this every time, you know, but I have to put like a branch here, otherwise the game won't let me progress. And this is the default. Now, if I select get angry and leave, Rara would flip the table, but that would not be in character.
Yeah.
So let's I do it and pretend it's not canon.
What? Hey, what? What?
It's kind of funny to, like, I
No, this isn't, no.
Close the door. Oh, you didn't close the door. God damn it. This is not canon, of course. Rara wouldn't do that. And we all know she wouldn't do that, so let's just all pretend that everything went civil. Like, she doesn't even have a reason to flip out. As far as I know. And we have a disc change. And here's the fake loading screens. And I'm glad somebody else agrees with me to always flip the tables. I usually select like boring options for the other two, like drink tea, have fun. And the last was just flip your shit and leave.
I mean, I like those first two. They're fine. We could have done that.
They're okay, yeah. But that was pretty, like, that was a thing that happened. It was pretty interesting to look at. In my opinion, at least. Obviously not in yours, but sometimes you just gotta face the facts that your friends are assholes who make you flip tables in video games.
Yeah, I was mind-controlled into doing that.
Sure, you were. I mean, she was. I made her do it. And I selected the wrong thing, but you can't see it. So that's good. Just means you gotta wait longer because of loading screens that will happen. So loading screen just started. Gonna let you know when it finishes. Okay, it finished, but it was a minor loading screen. Still pretty damn long though. And now reloading screen started. It's gonna be over any second now.
If you say so.
Yeah, now it's over. But that too was a shorter one. All it had to do was load a freaking menu. Where I select stuff. That's all it did. Literally nothing else. Okay, now it's gonna actually load something. That went quick. Okay, I'm confused. And now I need to save again before we can actually start this show, because that's how the game works.
That's so weird.
I wish I could show you how. I mean, I could show you, but I don't wanna. I think that's the entire reason I have these two stupid fucking loading screens up. Maybe. But here's a fake loading screen. Look at Shawn Michaels and his smug grin. Next we have the... This is Superstar Contenders match, right?
Maybe?
It is. Yeah, it is.
Oh, this is the Flaming Tables one, right?
Yes. I'm glad I could actually make this a Flaming Tables match. Because I wasn't sure.
Junpei was quite sure about it, so...
Well, yeah, okay, good. He knows more about WWE 2K14 than I do. Mainly because he actually watches VGCW. which I probably should do, but it's on at weird times for me. And the doctor is in. He looks so naked without a belt around his waist, though.
He's gonna fix that soon.
Maybe.
Not maybe. Definitely.
Loading procrastinates fun wrestling action. Let me write that down real quick. This is the best we've had so far ever. The most fitting one too. I hope that's not... Yeah, no, it's correct. Yeah, it's not like LPWFA like some people sometimes do. Well, unrelated. Not the best one today, the best one ever. I don't care how good yours were, this one's just better. Which is why I'm writing it down now instead of later. Because you don't know... Like, you don't know what I have to deal with when making this show. The amount of loading screens and the duration of them is unreal. It should be illegal to make a game that takes that long to load. The only thing worse is Sonic 06, where you have to endure like a 10 second loading screen to see a cutscene, quote unquote, where a character is there in engine and a text box appeared that has one sentence in it, and that's not a loading screen to load another thing. That's the only thing that could be worse than this.
Imagine if there was a loading screen before every entrance.
There technically is, but it's very short. It's one of the few times the game actually loads quickly. I don't know how can this happen, like... It's just poorly programmed. I'm not really very savvy in that regard, but I can't explain it any other way. And yes, that's quite the torso. It is clearly a human torso. And that's also clearly Stone Cold Steve Austin, another dinosaur wearing a man suit.
Yeah, I mean, I don't even know why you bring that up, because it's pretty clearly what that is.
Yeah, I don't know either. Honestly, I have no idea how you can confuse that shape for a dinosaur, but yeah. It's Stone Cold Steve Austin is the point. Mm-hmm. Oh yes. I almost forgot about Nufkin's secret power.
It was better when he materialized shirts out of his body just to rip them in half.
Well, Ghost of Ghost Dad. First off, this is the first time I actually read your name properly, and it's pretty cool, but I heard that they reprogrammed it for this game and just happened to make the same shitty bugs, but I can't believe that, honestly, because it literally has the same shitty bugs and more. So they somehow made it worse, which is amazing. You'd think they fixed things, maybe. They don't. Well, they clearly had to redo it for the more recent games, though, which is probably why the one feature I care about is missing. The creator story mode. Annihilated, since when are penguins green? Get real. And look at who's coming here. The guy who probably has a few cameras in our room right now. But he never looks at them, of course, because why would he want to see that? What the hell? Representing the Rockers?
What?
From Cambodia? That wasn't me.
Are you sure?
No. I think. Like, this is one of the bugs the game has, where it just, where it just puts random names of stables right there, like the announcer names of stables, because it puts people in random stables for story mode, more or less. It's not entirely random, there is a method to it, but there's a thread on the VGCW forums, which Junpei linked me to at some point in an effort to make me figure this shit out. And basically it boils down to save characters in specific slots and put the stables in specific slots too, and then hope for the best. And I'm not doing that.
That's way too much work.
Yeah, no, I'm not doing that. Especially because I would have to, because when people are in multiple stables or switch stables, I'd have to just rearrange my entire save file. And guess what? Copying a character? A loading screen. And that loading screen is fairly long. Well, actually it's just the saving icon in the bottom of the screen, but you... I think you understand what I mean here. It does take a while. Alright, music. I can't wait how long it takes for somebody to put somebody else through flaming tables, though, because this is a fatal four-way, so whoever puts somebody through a table first wins.
Okay, I was wondering about that.
And the other people will try to prevent them from doing that. But my guess is that somebody will set the table on fire, and then somebody will do a move, and it'll be pretty random, because one time I think Annie Lady kicked Junpei through the table. Which was cool, admittedly, but nobody saw that coming. Hopefully we'll see plenty of tables break before that, though, because that's what we're here for. Wrath is strategizing, of course. He walks around to the table and puts it somewhere.
He puts it right where he needs it 20 minutes from now.
Yeah. No. He puts it there, but he plans ahead. He knows that Napkins will take it and put it somewhere else because it's there now. And it'll be where he needs it.
Yeah.
I think Wrath is going to break the second table, he also broke the first. Oh, never mind, he just powerbombed it on the ground instead of the third table, because, again, he needs that table.
Yeah, he needs that table later.
Yeah, that's why he didn't break it.
That's the table he's gonna use to win.
If he does, I'm gonna... I don't know. Okay, if this is actually what happens, if Napkins then takes the table, puts it somewhere else, and then Wrath wins by putting somebody through the table, I will actually... I'm gonna tox right here. I don't have to anymore!
No!
Yes! Aww. I was gonna say I'm gonna make the rest of the characters I still need to make. No, I'm never gonna make him! Except I probably... Well, I didn't in weeks. I feel bad about that. Anyway, there's resting going on.
And maybe this is the table. Maybe we just got it mixed up. See, because Napkins took it. See?
But he took it back.
Well, that's
now I put it on the ground.
It's just his plan. Don't worry about it.
Sure. I can buy that. Because you know, Wrath seems like the calculating type, and he has very many interesting stories to tell.
Yeah.
And for a second I thought the table broke, but it didn't.
Nope, it's not broken.
Wait, was that a Stone Cold Stunner? Did he steal his finisher? He stole Knopkins' finisher? I didn't look for a second, I just saw the motion after the move. I looked at the other guys, and then I saw that. Well, it might be that he just stole Knopkins' finisher. I mean, Stone Cold Steve Austin's finisher. Or it might be a move that has a kind of similar motion afterwards, I don't know. I should find a way to just look at every character at the same time and focus on all of them. The King of Kings sign, by the way, is one of Wrath's signs. Obviously. Because Wrath is the King of Kings, even though he hasn't called himself that in a while.
Doesn't mean that he's not still the King of Kings.
Well, he has many names. I forgot most of them, though.
Yeah.
I just know Wrath. I know Dragonatrix.
Dragonatrix. Wrath, Lotus.
Lotus, yeah. Then Wrath Dragonatrix, too. But we just call him Wrath, because... yeah.
Oh, somebody's bleeding.
Hey, I told you there will be blood. Just, I expected it to come earlier. In...
You said there would be blood during your match with BNF.
I said maybe.
So...
there
will be blood. Oh yeah, you did say maybe, so... yeah.
I could have made the first blood match, though. Just to be sure. Oh, look. Oh, I thought for a second that he's gonna just set the table on fire, but... it always takes a while, and then it unceremoniously just ends the match somehow, because somebody's leg touches the table. That would be a pretty cool table break.
Yeah.
Like, that it was a pretty cool table break, but it would be better if the table was on fire in that moment.
But that would have meant Annihilated one.
Yeah, or that would have pissed off Chunpei. And that was number four.
Look at that table go.
I'd like to say that no tables were harmed in the making of this match, but that would be a lie.
Look at that! That table just went through the ring.
Much like Knopkins. Who faces halfway through the ring. Because he has such... well, unique proportions, and oh my god, it's happening.
It's the table.
Now nobody knows what's gonna happen, nobody knows who's gonna win. Just whoever can make a move close to the table first will win. Mm-hmm. This is gonna be intense.
So if somebody accidentally puts themselves through a table, who wins?
The table? The crowd goes nuts, of course. Oh my god, I saw that coming.
Whoa.
I was actively looking for moves that could break the table, and then it happened, so Pomp now has a shot at the title.
Yeah.
Which
that
is
pretty nice.
It's okay that Wrath didn't get it because he had that title in the past already.
Yeah, I can't complain because, I mean, Pomp was like my number two.
But Wrath can get angry at it again and just say, hey, I deserve that title even though I lost just now. I'm the King of Kings, I'm untouchable. Which I could swear something he said at some point. But only when I write him. If other people write him, he usually just says really... fucked up stuff. Like, he's the Grand Dragonatrix of the KKK, I remember that. Oh my god. Maybe Wrath should get more screen time again. It's been a while.
It has.
It's just I don't know enough about Wrath to write these stories.
Yeah. Not even, like, people who were close to Wrath know much about Wrath.
Well, we do know that he has a pool of children's tears and LSD.
Yeah. Yeah, we know he exists.
That too. We know that he makes Let's Plays sometimes. They're usually screenshot LPs.
Mm-hmm.
And look at that. Here comes Bun Bun with the entrance I didn't change. Makes
That's
it more
okay.
dramatic, though. As long as Bun Bun is out to destroy LPFWA...
Did you make Bun Bun more buff?
A little bit, yes. I hope it's noticeable.
It's not.
Yeah, of course it isn't. But she has normal proportions now, kinda, so that's cool. It's not like her arms are matchsticks anymore. You'll be able to tell, because those arms are thicker than that of the next contestant that will enter the ring.
Oh, well, yeah.
But the next contestant is a skeleton, so...
Yeah, a literal skeleton.
A literal skeleton called Bonette. Debuting today! Against a bunny! A bunny that is bent on destruction, apparently. Look at that slow walk. You know she's serious about destroying LPFWA. Since when do bunnies care about mass murder? I've never seen a bunny commit genocide before.
Annihilated is just delusional.
Yeah. Like, what was that earlier? He wanted bunny pizza? That was fucked up. I mean, Bun Bun may be a flawed person who wants to bring down LPFWA, but she's... Well, she's still a bunny, I guess.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I actually changed the song. Look at that skeleton.
Look at that skeleton.
I've never seen this before, by the way. I like that the skeleton has an eye patch.
Of course. Comes with the territory. I guess.
I also like that every character action Shakespeare makes has some kind of pirate hat. And weird proportions. Look at that fucking butt! Come on! Jesus Christ. I can't unsee it. I don't know why he picked that song, by the way. I have no idea. Just... I'm as confused as you are. You could say she's big-boned, I guess. Oh god, the skeleton puns. I've played Undertale, so I know a few. But I'm not gonna do it. Unless I find a good moment to do so. Maybe it would be funny if Bun Bun lost. I could say she's boned. That would be hilarious.
Well, you just wasted it.
No, I'm gonna say it again. It's gonna be great.
Oh, yeah, okay.
So, this is gonna be pretty amazing, though, because I have no idea how good Bonette is. I just know that Bun Bun has won a match before, I think. Maybe?
Bun Bun is a champion.
You mean she will be a champ? Who's the... I don't know. Is this actually evil now? Is it Aurora who's the champ? She don't know who's the champion right now is the problem.
It's probably evil.
I know I have not updated... I gotta ask Chunpei, he'll know for sure. Because he knows everything about LPFWA. Unless he doesn't, in that case, we're boned! Oh god, I wasted it again.
No, it's good. The more you use it, the more funny it is.
Oh, good. Because it's the one thing, the one skeleton pun I can think of right now. I'm not gonna say it again, though, for real. Because now we have chair shots. They're probably legal. Because this is a last woman standing match. Yeah, mm-hmm. I just remembered. So everything's legal. As long as
That's
it puts
right.
somebody down for long enough. Oh, I don't know if that actually does more damage, but Bonette just landed on the table and it looks like it interacted with the a chair. It's a table, right? I meant chair. God damn it. I'm still in the flaming tables match.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, this is the trash can. Feel free to visit it at any time. Wait, that's not a skeleton pun.
That's, no, it's not.
That's just a straight-up reference. I'm not gonna make this the Undertale appreciation stream again, though. I'm not gonna play the entire Undertale soundtrack in the background again. Instead, I'm gonna remember to put on the music, and it's gonna be something different, as you can hear. Oh my god, the sledgehammer. What will they do with it? I guess they're gonna gently poke people with it, because that's what people in wrestling do with sledgehammers. They also tend to make out with the hammers before they use them. At least that's a Triple H thing. I don't know why he does it, he just... stares into the eyes longingly of the sledgehammer and then he kisses it. He does that, for real. I'm not making this up. I'm actually not making it up, though. Oh no, an emulated has an opinion. I guess we're gonna have to,
Was that, like, Bonette's finisher, or...?
Maybe. Oh, yeah. They're doing things.
Bonette's doing pretty well.
Yeah, but that... I don't know what just happened, though, because that was weird.
Yeah, it was really weird.
The taunt, it's great. I like it.
Oh my goodness.
Is this... No, it's not it. Of course not.
I was about to say, not so early.
Yeah. Because to destroy LPFWA, Bun Bun needs to become the champion. And to become the champion, he needs to become the number one contender, and that's why she's here today.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Wait, is the trash can still in the ring? What? No, it's just the lid and a chair?
I can't even tell what that is.
It,
what is that?
It's the lid of the trash can and the chair, I think. Maybe. I can't be sure though, because it looks weird. Really weird.
Yeah, like what? I don't know.
I wish they'd pick it up. Wait, the flattened garbage can looks like that? It doesn't. It looks. It's really. It got compacted pretty much. Ah, the taunt again, I love it.
Come on, Bun Bun, get up! No, Bun
get
Bun!
Get up! No!
Oh my goodness.
Looks like Bun Bun can't stand up to the skeleton. See, I didn't say it again.
This is the worst.
Yeah. You could chase cheese defeated.
Yeah, you could say that.
You could. And the skeleton has anime music for some reason. And an enormous butt. Okay, I should call it hip bones though, technically, I guess. And now I think we have Pyroi and Loki, if I'm not mistaken.
Yep.
For the number one contendership of the LPFWA championship belt. Yep. Ah, there it is. Yeah. Like, I can't even read the stuff that's written around the edges because it had to turn my head, but I'm pretty sure it's,
number one contenders for all the glory and probably a cupcake, too.
Oh, yeah, right. There's a bunny sleeping at the commentator's table.
Yep, that's supposed to be me.
But you're not asleep right now.
Well, I can fall asleep during the match if you want.
Don't.
Okay,
I'd be on my own. And that would be horrible. I would cry. Tears of tears,
yeah.
Yeah, I was gonna say tears of blood, but then I realized no.
It's weird.
Yeah. I like Pyroi style. I should root for Loki because obviously Loki, but Pyroi looks cooler, and Pyroi has a cooler entrance, so I'm gonna root for Pyroi here.
I'm rooting for Loki.
I know. I am too, secretly, but... but you're not supposed to know that.
Oh, I don't. Don't worry.
Oh, good. Loki also has weird proportions. We have so many people with weird proportions, and so many people with anime songs as entrances too. I think we haven't seen Loki in a while now, though.
Yeah, it's been a while.
Loki star wins. Because wind is not an option, just Vince. I do it for a lot of people, by the way, just pick something that sounds similar. Like, Vince is obviously wind. And BFC is obviously chicken, 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 chicken.
Yeah.
Well, technically, I could just call him BFC. That's actually something the game lets me do.
Mm-hmm. But I'm not. But that's not as exciting.
Yeah. Chicken, 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 chicken is better. And we're actually going to see BFC next match. Because...
yeah, that's right.
Yeah, he's going to fight Big Papa Pump. The man who knows math real good. I think the match card Shunpei posted said something like Genetic Freaks Collide.
Yeah. We were trying to find, like, because we knew we wanted, we knew who we wanted them to face, but we didn't know, like, what the rationale would be behind it. So we were like, okay, is there anyone on the roster that's a genetic freak?
There's not just one guy. I mean... have you seen, Nafkins?
Yeah, I mean, but we were like, who here is a genetic freak that also isn't in any other match? And also, you know, it's just like...
yeah. Well, you know who else is a genetic freak? Boob Marley.
Yeah, that's true. We did consider that, but...
so, who's gonna win here? Punchy or Pyroi?
Haha, good joke.
That wasn't a joke. That was not a joke. We had Punchy versus Pyroi already, though. I forgot who won.
I think Pyroin, maybe.
I don't know. Like, I want to have two guys with boxing gloves fight each other. And of course, Big Papa Pump is a genetic freak. I mean,
yeah,
he says so himself all the time.
Yeah,
especially in his math promo, which I'm sure we'll not be hearing today, especially not as his entrance theme because I changed it. BFC actually reminded me of that without knowing it. Because he doesn't even know that there's gonna be a match with him today. Probably. So what's happening here?
Wrestling.
Yeah, I can see that. As far as
people
are doing things
to each other.
As far as I could tell, it's just like they're fighting, like normal, like there's no one who's dominating the fight so far. Except maybe Loki right
Loki's
now because
beating Pyro with a baseball bat, so
yeah. Maybe that's gonna change things. But this is a 2-3 falls anyway, so.
Mm-hmm.
Even if somebody gets pinned, they still have a chance to come back.
Well, usually though, with like 2-3, it's like you get that first one, then you're pretty much gonna get the second one right after.
I remember that time when 5 Palpatines fought 1 John Cena.
Yeah.
Or I think it was 3 Palpatines.
Yeah, 3 I think it was.
Because it can't make 5 versus 1. But that would be hilarious.
Nice
reversal. I want to see Pyro's finishing move because it's good.
Oh yeah.
Nice reversal again. It's not like these guys have anything to say or anything. Except if it's about coal miners every single fucking time. God damn it, I don't know. Like, if they have a line that's that distinctive, they should make sure that it happens less often. But, you know, it's WWE 2K14. What are you gonna do? Spoilers, Loki's not gonna tap. Because as far as we can see, he already didn't. I was gonna say that a little earlier, but I didn't. Yeah, do it, Pyroi. Do your thing.
Uh-oh.
It was an elbow drop. A fancy one, though. I like it.
Mm-hmm.
And holy crap. First one already? I didn't see that coming. I didn't think we'd go that quickly.
Someone's bleeding.
Oh, is that... what the hell?
Whoa, Sims magic.
Sims magic, and we see Pyroi's finisher. That could be it, though. That could actually be it.
I think that's probably it.
Yeah.
Wow, that was really quick.
Yeah, and also really weird in the end.
Yeah. Sims Magic knew what we wanted, though.
Yeah. The time fuckery. It happens. I forgot how Sims Magic even got the honor of being the one who's responsible for the time shenanigans.
I don't remember.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, I could have looked at the TV to see what we missed there, but I didn't know it was gonna happen, obviously.
Yeah.
But, oh well. Now we're just gonna see Scott Steiner versus... well, BFC. Last match of the evening.
Oh boy.
small drone, and you can say that statement is not true. See, normally if you go one-on-one with another wrestler, you got a 50-50 chance of winning. But I'm a genetic freak, and I'm not normal. So you got a 25% at best at beating me. Then you add Kurt Angle to the mix. Your chances of winning drastically go down. See, the three-way at sacrifice, you got a 33-1/3 chance of winning. But I got a 66-2/3 chance of winning, because Kurt Angle knows he can't beat me, and he's not even going to try. So, Samoa, you take your 33-1/3 chance minus my 25% chance, and you got an 8-1/3 chance of winning at sacrifice. But then you take my 75% chance of winning, and we used to go one-on-one, and then add 66-2/3%. I got a 141-2/3 chance of winning at sacrifice. See, McJoe.
The last sentence, unfortunately, is cut off. It's, the numbers don't lie, they spell disaster for you. I like these odds.
I like that even though Scott Steiner has over 100% chance, Samoa Joe still has some chance.
Yes.
He has like 8% chance. He still has a chance.
Yes, and his chance drastically go down. Remember that.
Yeah, but they still exist.
He's representing the undead. The undead is a stable that hasn't even shown up yet. Like, it exists for, like, it exists in the old LBWA too, but... It hasn't shown up in this one. I just made it for the hell of it. Like, the undead is Team Dark Souls, obviously.
Yeah.
What arena is this even? It's not a WrestleMania arena, I know that much. Like, normally we do this at WrestleManias, but I think we have all the cool ones behind us already. Like, we could go back to the one with the weird fire anytime, but I don't feel like it. Alright, this is No Way Out, because Scott Steiner was a member of the NWO, and No Way Out is abbreviated NWO. That works. Yes, the old theme for Team Dark Souls was the Ornstein and Smough theme. But the members were Krimsh, BNF, Chunpei, and me. Now that Krimsh is gone, it's Intrepid Jones. Because he was a co-commentator in the bonus videos for my Dark Souls 2 LP.
Yep.
Which I'm sure you already knew already, because you clearly watched it. But anyway, look at those two genetic freaks colliding. So what are BFC's chances of winning again?
8-1/3. I guess. I mean, maybe.
You know.
Well, this is only one on one, so probably 25.
Well, but the referee's also there. And the referee,
oh, yeah.
The referee is clearly biased.
So maybe 1 3/16% chance.
He has a chance.
Yeah.
But Scott Steiner's chance is over 100%.
Yeah. It's like 1003.
Yeah, we gotta just, you know, if BFC wins, he has a higher chance at winning. Wait, that's not how chance works. Okay, let's just pretend he has a 5 3/7 chance of winning. And Scott Steiner has like 100 however many percents he. Okay, anyway. Look at Scott Steiner kicking the shit out of that guy.
Yeah.
Oh my. You know, if some of you watch Botchamania, which probably some of you do, but there's this one segment in one of them, which has a match with Scott Steiner where he does the same fucking suplex like 20 times. And I haven't seen him do that particular suplex in this match yet. So he's probably saving it for something special. I think it's actually his finisher, the Steiner something-er. I guess all of his finishing moves are named Steiner something. I know he has the Steiner recliner, which I think is a camel clutch, if I'm not mistaken. I might be mistaken. Then he has the Steiner Bubba Bliner, and that's like a suplex or something, I guess. I haven't seen Scott Steiner wrestle since the WCW, and that was pretty bad. I don't know why I watched it. Anyway. Oh yeah, the Frankensteiner also exists. I forgot. And the Steiner screwdriver. Yes! It all comes back now. It all makes sense now.
That's good.
Well, I... No. Yeah, good. Good. And BFC got a punch, and I'm obviously rooting for BFC here because he has
of course
he has pink underpants and I like that.
And he's our friend.
Oh, he's a fourth assless chaps wearer. Holy crap.
Hey,
I said
there
were only three, but there's four. I forgot. How could I forget BFC?
Yeah, how he's, rude.
He's been on commentary before. He's been on the writing team. What? God damn it. Why is he? I shouldn't have forgotten him, obviously, because well, I feel bad now. And that's... I think the Steiner recliner? That should be the Steiner... no, that's a Frank. I don't know. They're all called Steiner something. Steiner screwdriver, Frankensteiner, Steiner recliner. I forgot which is which. And... he did not tap. Good.
Nope, he didn't.
The only wrestling I watch these days is Lucha Underground. I don't even know what WWE stands for anymore. That's not true, I know. But it looks like Scott Steiner's actually dominating this match, so maybe his math didn't lie.
I don't know.
But
I think BFC can pull it out.
I believe in BFC.
Yeah. He's got a chance, kind of, maybe.
Yeah, what do you say, a 5/3/7 chance of winning?
Yeah, I think so.
Or something. I also like how Scott Steiner just switches from fractions to decimals all the time. That's great. I bet my math teacher would love if I did that. Not that I have a math teacher anymore, because I'm clearly a grown-up.
A grown-up?
Look at that shit I'm doing in my free time. Look at it right here on the screen. And now he tapped.
Oh, there it is. The genetic freak wins.
Yeah. I keep choking that Scott Steiner has a degree in math, but... It would be hilarious if that were actually true. Oh, the music. Your chances of winning drastically go down. See, the three-way at Sacrifice, you got a 33 1/3 chance of winning. Okay. So that's LPFWA, but before we go.
Mm-hmm. You know they say all men are created equal. But that means you that small Joe, and you can see that statement is not true.
See, normally if you go one on one with another wrestler, you got a 50-50. Because we missed the very important last sentence. And I'm not normal.
So you got a 25% at best.
Just gotta hear it in its entirety.
And then you add Kurt Angle to the mix. Your chances of winning drastically go down.
Even though we heard it in the previous stream, because I just played the video on stream.
But I got a 66 2/3 chance of winning, because Kurt Angle knows he can't beat me, and he's not even gonna try. So Samoa Joe, you take your 33 1/3 chance, minus my 25% chance, and you got an 8 1/3 chance of winning at Sacrifice. But then you take my 75% chance of winning, if we used to go 1-on-1, and then add 66 2/3%, I got a 141 2/3 chance of winning at Sacrifice. See, Joe, the numbers don't lie, and they spell disaster for you.
It gets
Sacrifice.
Funnier every time, I don't know why. Oh, don't start again, no. Okay, this is how we close this week's show, I guess.
I suppose.
Yeah, thanks for joining us, everybody.
Have fun in 2024.
Yes, it's going to be a great year. I hope. See ya.
Yeah.